because this Bukit Bintang's first year in Parliament. All the members of Parliament. This is the highlight because you can hear Star Wars in the background. So he basically says this draft plan can be used as guidelines. But he refuses to gazette because he says there's a lot of things that are considered kepincangan, flaws in the plan. So basically, you know, I don't know, because we were asked to sign a non-disclosure agreement under the Official Secrets Act when we wanted to view the plan, the KL draft plan. So, you know, we've come to a point where we are saying to preserve, to save, to secure Kuala Lumpur, we must gazette the draft plan. There is no way around it, yeah? So, for the next point, I think when you look at this, even this, I'm talking about the buffer zones initially, and you have riverside corridor. Do you build homes beside the river? No, of course not. You have heritage zones, like Merdeka, Station Ketapi. These are the zones that require buffer around them, surrounding them, yeah? Including the height control zone, Istana Negara in Damansara, for example, yeah? And transit planning zone, you have, I know whether it is KL Central. Remember, KL Central, mainly MRCB project. There are houses of worship, there are NGOs in Brickfields, the Malaysian Association of the Blind is there. You need to prioritize micro needs. There's a school, there's a church in Brickfields, not just making it a traffic hub. You see, it's very crucial to understand why the overly planning controls will impact the traffic, the pressure, the stress levels at any given area. Okay? Next. So this is one of the examples when we were trying to preserve Bukit Gasing. I think Bukit Gasing is one of the remaining remnants in Kuala Lumpur. On PJ side, parts of it is gazetted. In Kuala Lumpur, it has been reduced in size, and we still have not succeeded in getting the mayor to fulfill some of the promises. And this is the urgent motion, which was rejected by the speaker. We wanted to compel the Minister of Federal Territory to basically explain more on the gazettement of the draft plan, and to explain as to what are the flaws or kepincangan. What exactly, because we have said to him, we are willing to meet, but we are not willing to basically back down from the demand of gazetting the draft plan. As we are speaking, can you imagine how many projects in your home area that has been approved without any ability for you to say anything? Because it only requires approval of Pengarah Perancang Bandar, Datuk Bandar, Menteri Wilayah. So buatlah Kaedah 5. Come on lah, I've been there. What they say under Kaedah 5, bantahan is being abused by all the members of parliament to instigate anger amongst the citizens, to be angry at the KL and start a riot. So, I mean, I explained to him no such thing, but in my experience, 99.9% of all the Kaedah 5, yeah, Kaedah 5 objections that I've been to have met with, it was futile. Next. So that's why we, at the end of this, in terms of, you know, Datuk Mumtaz from Bukit Bandar Raya asked me, what are you going to do? So I am more than happy to give you the guidelines as we prepared, and we do need to push for as many residents for the gazettement of the draft plan. Because I feel and I fear in the last session from the minister's answer, he's not going to do such a thing. And I mean, I live in Segambut Dalam in my father's house at the moment, and I can tell you I have no idea how many more sprouting developments will take place. The roads are completely, you know, at boiling point. There's no way we can withstand. Traffic will take from 45 minutes to an hour every single day, and we can only rely on DBKL Jabatan Pengangkutan Bandar to tell us, have you planned something? So for me, there is a plan. It's called the KL Draft Plan, and I will not allow anybody to deny us the right to have a plan for a better and more deserving Kuala Lumpur for its people in the future. Thank you. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi
wabarakatuh. You ask, when we trace up, before we invite...